Hey folks, this is Vince with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and once again we're going to commentate on a game of X-Wing that Benny and I recently played. I am the Rebel Alliance. I've got a Y-Wing, Gold Squadron Pilot, R3A2, BTL, A4 Y-Wing, and Twin Laser Turret. Blue Squadron Pilot, B-Wing, Fire Control System. Got another one of those, same deal. And same thing, except I've got Intelligence Agent and B-Wing E2 modification on this one. And Vinny is playing as the Imperials. Merrick Steel, TIE Advanced, Expertise, TIE X1, Title, Advanced Targeting Computer, and Stealth Device. Quick Draw, TIE Fighter, Special Forces, Expertise, Fire Control System, Weapons Guidance, Lightweight Frame, and Special Ops Training. And we've got Zeta Leader, Wired, Stealth Device, and Weapons Guidance. It's a First Order TIE Fighter. Okay, so here we go again. My goal was to basically overwhelm him with my B-Wings, if at all possible. My B-Wings don't have a lot of agility, but they do have 3 attack dice each. Fire Control System will allow me to acquire a target lock after an attack, which is nice. So I can focus on, well, taking focus actions after I get my target lock on the next round, assuming I survive. I've got relatively low pilot skills. That's the downside to this build. He'll be able to shoot first, and he could take me out before I get a chance to do anything, if I'm not careful. The Y-Wing is set up so that the title will allow it to, basically, it prevents it from using a turret in a 360 manner. It can only shoot out of its primary firing arc. However, I can fire my primary weapon and then fire my secondary turret weapon in the same round. So I can fire twice, but I'm limited to my primary firing arc. And with R3A2 and the twin laser turret, I can just continue to add stress to whatever ship I want. Whenever I declare the target of my attack, basically I can add a stress token to him, but I have to take one myself. So the Y-Wing is going to be taking a lot of stress in order to give my opponent lots of stress because I'll be firing a lot with that thing. Twin Laser Turret does fire twice. Vinny's got more upgrades than I do. Zeta Leader basically is, if you're not stressed, you can take a stress token to add an extra attack die to your roll. He's also got Stealth Device on Zeta Leader and Weapons Guidance. He can cancel all dice results with that thing and add 2 hit results to the roll. Wired, I think it's whenever he's stressed, he gets to re-roll all focus, whether he's attacking or defending, which is kind of nice. So basically, he can stress himself out to attack, and then use Wired when he's defending, which is kind of nice. Quick Draw, we've seen Quick Draw before, but basically, whenever he loses a shield, once per round, Quick Draw may attack again, so he basically gets a second attack once he loses his shield. And Vinny forgot his shield's tokens, apparently. He's got Expertise, which allows him to turn all focuses into hits, so as long as he's not stressed. He's got Fire Control, Weapons Guidance, Special Ops Training. I can't see the rest of it. I don't have a photographic memory either. Merrick Steel, that ability is basically whenever I get a crit, he gets to deal... Well, he gets to look at 3 damage cards, choose one, and give me that crit, which is pretty powerful with the advanced targeting computer that he's got. And the advanced targeting computer basically, so as long as he has a target lock on me, he can add a crit to his roll, so as long as he doesn't spend the target lock. I do believe he has stealth device on him too. So he's running some high pilot ships there. But relatively weak in terms of hit points, although Quick Draw does have 3 shields and 3 hull, but only 2 agility. So again, my goal here was to, when I saw Merrick Steel off to the side like that, I was like, okay, he's going to swoop in at some point. So I've got to take one of those TIE fighters out, the ones that I'm jousting with straight ahead of me. I wasn't sure which one I'd be attacking first, whatever one was in range. Quick Draw, I did not want to attack right away because, again, his ability allows him to fire again, and I didn't want to give him that extra hit. I wanted to survive as long as possible because, again, my ships are very low agility ships. They're only 1 agility each. So I need to take stuff out quickly before his weapons just blow me away. All right, so we're closing in here. And again, we fly casually, so if we make roll mistakes or whatever, it's not that big of a deal. Barely made that one. He's going to take a barrel roll so he doesn't wreck into the debris on the next turn. All right, so it looks like Quick Draw is going to shoot. Now, the middle B-Wing, the one he's targeting, has the intelligence agent and the title, which I forgot to use this game. I hate doing that. I sometimes equip upgrades that I never use. All right, so he's got 3 hits there. I've got, I spent my focus, took an evade, so I lose 2 damage on that B-Wing. Or 2 shields, rather. Okay, so Zeta Leader is. Okay, so he doesn't get anything off of that, but he does get fire control system. Or no, that was Quick Draw that got fire control system. Zeta Leader is taking a stress to fire an extra attack die. Looks like a hit and 2 crits there. I rolled an evade, took 2 more damage on that metal beam. That's what I'm saying. Like, I have low pilot skills, so he can. He's getting first hits by the one B-Wing is already down to 1 shield, so that's 4 hit points left on the middle B-Wing, so I've got to try and take him out quickly here, if I can. And try and get my Y-Wing to deny actions if at all possible. So I'm shooting at range 3 with my primary. I'm going to stress myself out. Using R3A2, rolled a hit. He gets 5 defense, which he rolls easily. I don't know why, he's rerolling for wired. I don't know why, but he already blocked the attack. I guess he just wanted to show off. All right, so now my twin laser turret kicks in. Basically, twin laser turret, I have to cancel all dice results. If I hit him, I cancel all dice results and I give him 1 damage, which I did. So he loses a shield. Second roll on twin laser turret attacks twice. Again, it's another hit. So he takes 1 face down damage card. All right. So Zeta Leader is hurt. And I didn't perform my R3A2s with the Y-Wing on a twin laser turret just because I didn't think Zeta Leader would last that long. So I was hoping my B-Wings could take him out, and then my Y-Wing would be somewhat stress-free to stress out either the TIE Advanced or Quick Draw. Okay, so the B-Wings are now attacking Zeta Leader, just trying to focus him down. 1 hit. One crit. Yeah, he's got 3 evade, no damage. And he's rolling a lot of defense dice. He's got stealth device and he's at range 3, so that's 5 defense. But my fire control systems kick in. I get target locks all on Zeta Leader there. And now Merrick Steel will more than likely come in and try and do some damage. Okay, so I'm gonna have to deal with another round of punishment. Again, he gets to fire first, so if he targets my one B-wing, he could possibly blow it up, that middle one there. I've only got 3 hull left and 1 shield, so it's gonna take 4 hits, knock me out. All right, so my Y-wing is just gonna go 1 straight. Removes the stress. Takes a focus. I'm hoping to take out Zeta Leader with one of my B-Wings and then use the Y-Wing's ability on Quick Draw to try and stress him out. Deny him some actions. So my B-Wing, I decided the one B-Wing, the middle one that's hurt, I moved up as far up as I could. The TIE fighters, from my understanding, don't have a one straight, although I didn't realize that the special forces did, but the regular TIE fighters do not. So I was hoping that he would just wreck into me and try and deny him some actions if at all possible. But he's got two stress on his one Zeta leader already, so he wouldn't be able to take an action anyway. All right, so he's gonna bump here. Removes one stress, but he's still stressed. He's got one stress token left. And Zeta leader, okay, Merrick Steele's moving. Taking a target lock on the Y-wing for advanced targeting computer, more than likely. And quick draw moves up one. I didn't realize that they could do that. So yeah, now quick draw is in perfect range here for killing that B-wing. So I gotta try and stay alive if at all possible. All right, so he gets four tact dice, one for his special ops training and one for range one. His expertise kicks in there, four hits, got one focus. I've got to use the focus token to keep myself alive because I'd take four hits and that would kill me. So I took one shield gone and two damage cards. So my B-wing is close to death. All right, so here comes. All right, two shields gone on the one B-wing. And now Merrick Steele gets to shoot. Two focus. Okay, I think he's using weapons guidance there and then adds a crit to the roll. And I lose three shields. So the Y-wing is now shieldless. And all right, so the B-wings are shooting back. He gets, looks like, two damage here on the First Order pilot, and he's out. So Zeta Leader is gone. So we're just cleaning up stuff now. And now quick draw. This is what was hurting me here. I mean, as soon as I attack quick draw and remove his shield, he gets to shoot back and destroy my B-wing. So I was like, do I really want to do this? So I decided to, just he was gonna die soon anyway. So I fired with him first because more than likely he'd attack him. All right, so fire control systems kicks in there. Now the other B-wings are shooting. All right, he has one hit, loses a shield, but now he gets to attack back per his ability. And four attack dice, he's going after that B-wing. That's three hits, four hits. Yeah, that B-wing is toast. So yeah, that is the beauty of quick draw. So that's one B-wing down. Now my other B-wing gets to shoot at quick draw. He can't attack back here because he's already used that one ability once. So it looks like he loses one shield. Y-wing shooting now. So two attack dice. Now the obstacle will give him three attack or three defense, so he does not get to use lightweight frame. Because he's got more defense than attack, or there's less attack than defense. All right, so what's he doing? He's spending his focus. All right, twin laser turrets kicking in. Looks like he lost a shield there, possibly. Yeah, we were discussing the whole, because he has lightweight frame, but at the same time, like that, you have to. The way lightweight frame works is after you roll your defense dice, if there are more attack than defense, you get to roll an additional defense. So because he had three already from the obstacle, he did not have more than me, so it did not kick in. He wanted to roll four there, but he could only roll three. All right, so quick draw takes a damage via twin laser. I'm taking a stress to give him a stress twice. No damage, but all right, so I stressed him out twice with the Y-wing with twin laser turret. I decided not to stress him out a third time because I was hopeful that I could kill him before, before he'd use up all of his stress or, get rid of all of them. Okay, so there's two B-wings and a Y-wing left, TIE Advanced that's untouched, and Quick Draw, which is, looks like damaged, one damage card. So he's got two haul left on that. And his ability no longer applies because he no longer has any shields. If there was a way for Quick Draw to regenerate shields, that would just be OP. All right, so we're trying to come up with stuff here. I probably could have used, I could have used R3A2 on the Y-Wing to give him a third stress token, but again, I was hopeful that I wouldn't have to use. I mean, three stresses on a Y-Wing, like, really limits its maneuverability. All right, so that was a one slight turn on my part. Should have removed the stress there. I don't know why I didn't. I thought a one slight turn was a green maneuver. Maybe it's not on a Y-Wing. All right, so 2K turns all around for the B-Wings. I have stress on both, but I still have my target locks via advanced targeting computer. And quick draw moves three straight. He does have a auxiliary firing arc. Now, Vinny was trying to fire twice with that thing. The way that card works. All right, now he lands on. Here's Merrick Steel. He lands on the debris. He has to roll for a crit and take a stress. But anyway, Quick Draw's ability basically is, or the special ops rather. If you decide to add an extra attack die, you can do one of two things. You can either give yourself an extra attack die out of the forward firing arc, or you can fire out of the front and in the rear using your normal attack. He was trying to fire twice out of his rear firing arc, and that's not how the card works, but we worked it out. Okay, so it looks like I took some damage on the one B-Wing. Two hits from the looks of it. And this is where we were talking about the whole rear firing arc, front firing arc, how the card works, that kind of thing. Like he wanted to fire twice, but. All right, so here comes the TIE Advanced. Shooting at the Y-Wing. That's two crits. So I get. He has to choose two face-up crits for me. That's one direct hit and two direct hit. Yeah, he unfortunately there were two direct hits in those two decks of three that I gave him, and he did five damage to my Y-Wing right out and just knocked it out. That's just terrible. Merrick Steel. All right, it looks like Quick Draw is out after receiving two hits. So that leaves two B-Wings and a TIE Advanced. Who will win? Merrick Steel has. He has one shield. I don't know why that is. I think Vinny rolled for damage, rolled a hit, and thought he had to take a hit, but I think he gets a shield back. I think he re recognizes that and gets a shield back at some point. Now, the way Vinny's maneuver works here, we end up talking for a little bit about how moving through an obstacle works. And unfortunately, I land on the obstacle myself here. But Vinny's maneuver here, his template will overlap an obstacle. Vinny didn't feel that he needed to take another stress token and lose his action, like, because he was already on it. But as you can see, the template overlaps the obstacle. And Vinny was, I don't want to say arguing, but he was a strong component of being able to take an action because he was already. And not to take a stress and take an action because he was already on it, and basically, you know, he it basically ignores like he would ignore the effects of that obstacle because he's already on it. But my thing was, the rule book says that whenever you maneuver a ship and it overlaps an obstacle, then you have to take whatever. You know, whatever consequences result from that, whether it be an asteroid or a debris cloud. So I ended up, you know, we ended up doing the latter. He didn't take his action. All right, he's gonna go ahead and attack here, the B-Wing at range two. So one hit, and now my B-Wings shoot back. And okay, so three hits and. What's he doing? Okay, so he took a damage, I think? Possibly. All right, so that's one, two. Target locks. Okay, so he's got enough there. So Merrick Steele is now shieldless. However, he's still in the game. He's got 3 agility. He loses his stealth device, though, as the result of that. So now it's just going to be a little fancy footwork here, trying to get my B wings to get some sort of bead on this Tide Vance. Tide Vance are very maneuverable. My B wings are both stressed, so they can't do very much right now. And it looks like we're still discussing the whole debris issue. All right, so I think we got it resolved. We're moving. One slight turn removes one stress. And I wasn't sure which way he was going to go. I didn't know if he was going to go right or left. So I wanted to try and get it, clear my stress out as much as possible. Now, I did do a too hard turn here, which was a white maneuver, so I didn't clear my stress. But I didn't know if he was going to go right or left. So I was trying to plan for every contingency here. He goes forward, clears his stress, and decides to do a bearer roll to get out of my arc, which he does. Okay. So again, very maneuverable. And now my B wings might seem like they have the upper hand here, but again, they have 5 shields and 3 hull, and Merrick Steele does have that ability. So if he clears the shields out on these B wings and manages to continue with the crits, he'll be able to choose really nasty crits here to cripple my B wings. All right, so my B-wing moves forward, clears stress, and decides to bearer roll, just so we can possibly turn around. This one does a too hard turn here. Remains stressed. I didn't think he'd be able to shoot me, which he can't. So basically, we're just jockeying for position at this point. He's taking a target lock on me. Now, this next move will more than likely result in an engagement. And I've got one B-wing in the fight, which is not what I want. I wanted to attack his TIE advance with both at the same time. But it is what it is. All right, 2K turn. And he's doing a too hard turn. So we are gonna fight this round for sure. He's got a target lock and a focus. All right. He's at range 1. He's going to add a crit to the result, and expertise kicks in. So that's 3 damage. Now, here's the thing. I lose 2 shields. Now he gets to choose one damage card to give me. And it ends up being Blinded Pilot, which means I cannot attack this round. So that was an excellent choice on Vinny's part. Merrick Steele, his ability this game really worked for him. He did 5 damage to the Y-Wing with direct hits. He was able to choose those, and he was able to choose that blinded pilot, so I could not attack. And that was devastating for me because I was at range 1 with a B-wing. That's 4 attack dice, and he had nothing, no evade, no focus, and he couldn't use anything. So it's just, yeah, it was just unfortunate. He didn't use expertise, he used a focus, I think. I don't know if he has, he might have expertise. I can't tell. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Alright, so my other B-wing's moving in now. Still has 4 shields on it, so. All right, one hard turn here. All right, 3 slight turn. The one hard turn stressed my B-wing out, but basically I wanted to stay out of his firing arc if at all possible. All right, my other B-wing has 4 shields on it, so I'm fairly confident. He's shooting. Actually, he doesn't have a target. Nope. His arc is, it's just barely out of arc. So I end up rolling 3 dice here. Use focus, 3 hits. He's got no evade at all. So he has to take 3 hits and he's out. So that was an excellent game on Vinny's part. Again, Merrick Steele, wonderful pilot, and it worked very well for him, especially with his advanced targeting computer. If you guys want to see more gameplay, let me know. If you guys haven't already, subscribe to my channel and check out my official website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vince. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.